Good afternoon. Welcome to That's Oregon Live with Rick Dancer. This is Explorigan, and we are on the beach outside of Driftwood Shores in Florence, Oregon right now. And what you're looking at is the first time ever here in Florence. Now, maybe families got out and played beach soccer, but this is Copacabana Beach Soccer. It's done all over the world, and now it's done right here in Florence today. It's been here for 2 days, yesterday and today, and the guys who started this whole thing are right here with me. Let me turn this over. All right, gentlemen, and these are local guys. You can tell by their accent.
There you go, absolutely.
So you are?
I'm Jeff Sunday.
And?
Christian Wagner.
Chris, get right over next to him. Over next to this guy. There you go. Yeah, you
are.
So what is Copacabana Soccer, beach soccer?
Well, Copacabana Beach Soccer, we named it after the beaches of Copacabana. Beach soccer was really popular decades ago.
So this started in Brazil.
It started in Brazil. Well, Brazil claimed it. I mean, we've played it in Europe, so there's of course international pride. We played it in Europe. We played on the beaches in the summer, but in Brazil, it actually really got organized. They started out 11 versus 11. They took regular teams, and then it whittled down and became more popular. It's 5 against 5, so including one goalie. So one goalie and 4 players. And they played it started actually formalizing it and coming up with a set of rules and dimensions. And out of that grew beach soccer worldwide. And out of that grew when FIFA took charge of that. Then it became really formalized and it created a World Cup. So they have an annual World Cup. Beach soccer and about 60, 70 Asians take part in that.
So you guys, when you come on here, tell me where you're watching from, okay? So we know what town or what country or whatever it is that you're watching from. Why is this so popular? Why do you think it's going to grow from beach? Since it's here, this is the first time in Florence, but why do you think this will really take off here?
Well, from experience, we started Copacabana Beach Soccer in California, in Santa Monica. Just like we've done here in Florence with 30 teams, and over the last 11 years we now have over 300 teams participating in our tournament. So
how many were here today or this weekend?
This weekend we had 25 teams.
For local people, you're trying it here, you're trying to see how it works.
Right.
Yeah, local people from the local counties. We've got Newport folks, we've got some teams actually come from Crescent City, California, and we've got some teams from Portland. We've got some co-ed adult teams from Eugene.
So why do people like beach soccer more, you know, or why is this so much fun?
It's a variety of reasons. When I grew up, we played soccer in the beach all summer long, but it was kind of just pickup games. What it does for you, it increases your stamina. There's very low impact, so anybody can play, and older players are returning to the beach because it is low impact. What's popular about it is, of course, in the summer, you're ahead 100%, and then playing soccer on top of that. So that's what people like. When we started it, we created it as a family destination. Actually, Jeff had a club in LA, and it was started at the end of the season as getting your families out on the beach and just informally play beach soccer, which then grew into a tournament over the next couple of years. And then Jeff and I teamed up and really blew it up and started going nationwide.
So what is hope for this in terms of Oregon and what we do here?
Well, what our game plan is really is moving up the coast. We've already been invited by Newport. There's areas up in Seattle, there's Washington, and we actually want to go up as far as Canada. So the sport's really getting known, and towns and communities and clubs and parks and recs and for instance, just like the city like Oregon, the Eugene Coastal Cascade Sports Commission contacted us and said that they've heard that we put on a great event, and it's really a popular event, and would we like to come out and get it going up here in Florence. And we came out here and saw the opportunity and met some really nice people, and then the Driftwood Shores have been very helpful with us and helped facilitate us in producing the tournament this year. And from all the from 12, 13 years old coming up to our trailer saying, hope you guys are going to come out here again next year, and definitely will be. Every tournament that we have started over the 11 years, over the second, third year, have grown, doubled, tripled. So we're here to stay and to make this exciting and to bring a lot of families from all of Oregon, from Portland, from Eugene, and to come and compete with each other in a fun way, and to have a terrific summer vacation out of it.
Well, thanks you guys. Let me talk to Traveling Cat. You got one more thing?
Actually, what we've done over the years is since all the families come up, and we've geared it towards families now. We do about education as far as nutrition, hydration. We bring in experts. We bring in coaches to train our coaches. We bring in a referee coordinator to train referees. So we've really looked at it holistically to make this a big sport in the United States. And Beach Soccer Worldwide actually has contacted us a couple of times and praised us for what it is that we're doing for beach soccer. So it's been great.
Guys, thank you so much. Hang on, I'm going to go talk to Jessica. Jessica, come here, my dear. So this is the woman responsible for all this.
Hello.
Jessica, tell them who you are.
Hi, I'm Jessica Shefferman from the Eugene Cascades and Coast Sports Commission.
So you guys contacted them.
Yes. So Joey Jewell from our staff is our sales and development director, and he reached out to Copacabana and had them come up for a site visit, and they were looking to make a move to Oregon. So
why is this such a good fit for Florence?
One, the dunes and the beach are amazing, and it's really great to showcase that to our friends in California and all the other states. It's really unique, which goes with all the other events that we try to bring out to the area.
So the Sports Commission does a lot of things people really don't know about.
Yes.
Tell me what other things you guys are planning.
So I know that we're also working on bringing some other events out to the Florence area. We've been talking with a windsurfing tour to bring out beach volleyball, those kinds of things.
Oh, gosh, that would be
more
fun.
More to come.
So the whole idea is to get tourists not only to stay in Eugene, Springfield, but
yes,
to get them out to Florence,
mm-hmm,
give them some things to do out here.
Absolutely.
And you guys are going and you're kind of looking for the wild and wacky.
That
we're not used to.
That we're not used to.
Because soccer is not unusual, but on the beach.
But on the beach, yeah.
Right.
I mean, you can't beat these views. You get to watch a great soccer game and watch the tide come in. So hopefully not too far in, but you know.
Okay, Jessica. Hey, thank you, Jessica.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, Andy, come here, man. So, hold on, guys. I got to show you. This is Andy Vivora from Travel Lane County. But I got to show you. This is really the star right here.
That's Baxter.
And Baxter's kind of the head. He's kind of in charge of his whole new thing with Travel Lane County, isn't he?
He is. He is experiencing Lane County firsthand. So this is his first time to the beach, and you can see he likes the sand. And we're going to go out and see the water here in a little bit. But he is going around experiencing adventures all over Lane County and then blogging with them.
So Andy and his dog basically are going out and showing you new things about Lane County. I didn't know you were doing this, and I saw it online, and I went, that's a great, they were out kayaking the other day at Fern Ridge, right?
At Fern Ridge,
which,
yeah,
by the way, folks, if you haven't been out, it looks so good right now. We drove by it today on the way here. It's all full. It looks great. So what's the gig between you two then? Who are you trying to get to?
Well, we want to just show everybody, obviously, all the great things about Lane County, but also all the fun things you can do with a dog. And so this is a four-month-old yellow lab, and one of the things, the next vlog after today, in experiencing the ocean, I'm going to write about all the great restaurants, the breweries, the wineries, the restaurants in Eugene that are dog-friendly. So those places you can take your dog with you, sit out, have a meal on the patio, and
so
enjoy
that. So Travel Oregon's going to the dogs. Travel Lane County. Well, Travel Oregon.
Yeah,
so you're all together. That's a great idea. I really liked it. So you guys,
I got it from Jess. She started her blog last year with her dog.
So now you're just copying.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, that's a great form of flattery, right, Jess? You know, that's how it works. So what else is going on in Lane County that people need to know about?
A lot of fairs and festivals this month. So
today's the Blackberry. Is it Blackberry Jam?
Oh, it's coming up.
Coming up.
Yeah, it's coming up. The Blackberry Jam out in Lowell. So that's one of them. But also, we've got Cobra Golden Years. It's coming back. Break, but they're coming back in the 50th anniversary, so head out to Cobra. That's in July. It's in July. These are all in July that I'm mentioning. We've got full slate in July, so we've got Blackberry Jams coming up. We've got Cobra Golden Years. We've got Bohemia Mining Days, which is always a fun one down at Quainer Park in Cottage Grove. Obviously, the Lane County Fair has got a full slate going over at the fairgrounds.
Don't forget forget the Oregon Country Fair.
Oregon Country Fair is
that's
huge.
That's big.
Yeah, yeah.
And so then just, I'll throw one in there for, because we're doing the car show in Coburg Car Show on the, I think it's the 5th of August. It's that first weekend in August, and that's a big, we went there last year with them, and that was a huge deal.
Yeah, those are a lot of fun. Jumping back to June 30th, we've got the Dead & Company out at Austin Stadium. There's probably still some tickets left for that. But also on that day, over at the fairgrounds, you have Eugene Food Truck Fest. I know you've been doing food truck.
We're going to be out there on Friday, this coming Friday, to promote it. They're bringing out some trucks for us so we can show you guys what they're going to do. But that's a great fundraiser.
Great fundraiser for the Eugene Mission. So go out and support them. And then if you've got tickets to the Dead & Company, head over to Austin with a full stomach. Just a little bit of a teaser, we're going to put together something called Savor Springfield. So we're going to have a little passport program for a very short period of time, August 5th through the 10th, and that's in celebration of opening a public house over at the formerly called Stratton.
I was going to be there last night.
Last night. Okay, so they are opening up. Their beer hall is almost ready. So that's the next thing to open up. They've opened up the outdoor bar, and then the Abbey space is going to become the whiskey lab.
Right.
They're going to have featured whiskeys and tequila. And so we're going to have an opening week of activities over in downtown Springfield called Savor Springfield. Pick up a passport, you visit a bunch of these restaurants and breweries in downtown Springfield, and you can win prizes.
And you guys are also part of the passport that's going on with the Parks Eugene. Where you can pick up a passport for $5 at their offices, both their offices. You can visit 26 of the different food carts around town, and there's prizes. And even by just buying $5, and even if you go to two food carts, you say,
yeah, it's a great program, so we're excited about that. And there are so many great food trucks. It's amazing.
All right, you guys. So, again, this is Beach Soccer Club of Savannah. First time in Lane County, first time in Florence, probably not the last time. Local people came out playing soccer on the beach, learning new activities. Java Lane County is trying to bring new kinds of sporting events to our area. We can experience something a little different. I love that.
Yeah, and we love having it over here in Florence. Florence is a great destination to host your meetings. We've got the Florence Event Center, great hotels like Driftwood Shores, like all the hotels down on the riverfront. So definitely come over here to Florence, bring your meetings to Florence. It's just a great spot, especially when it's 80 degrees in the valley and it's beautiful over here today.
So is our audio, it's probably the beach air, the wind. Somebody says, oh, your audio's terrible. And it could be different people that's out there too. Okay, so one more person we want to talk to real fast. Where are you, Tammy? So Driftwood Shores, you kind of hosted this.
Hello.
Didn't you?
Yeah, so we're honored to be chosen by Copacabana and have the teens out here this year, and really looking forward to next year's event. They have tons of interest from all over Oregon, so if you didn't make it out this year, definitely check it out for next year.
Okay, and we're going to be showing you right behind that Driftwood Shores in just about, what is it? Well, probably about a half an hour. We're going to do another live remote right here on That Oregon Life, and we're going to show you and introduce you, because you guys did a renovation.
Yeah, we're right in the middle, and we're sold out, so we're going to show you what we have, but definitely stay tuned.
All right, so we'll be back in just a few minutes. I'm Rick Dancer. This is Explore Again, and we are on That Oregon Life. Thanks for watching. Share this on your page if you would. We'd really appreciate it. All right, see you later.